Okay, so here's a quick little ab workout. Do it along with me. I'll be talking to you and showing you how to do each exercise. And just make sure to push yourself, and this will give you nice flat abs. So come along with me. Alright, so the first one, I call them either track sit-ups or in and outs. Basically, you go out and in, and try and keep balance. You can have your arms right here. Oh god. Yeah, you need a lot of balance for these. And just engage your core, keep it tight. Go in, out, in, out. And keep your back straight. And your arms straight too. Keep going, bring them in and out. Don't let your legs or arms touch the ground. The only thing that should ever touch the ground is your butt, not even your back. You can't touch the ground with anything. Okay, let's do five more. Five, four, come on, three more. Three, two, and one. Okay, now the next one are side crunches. I do these kind of differently than other people might do them. So basically, I lay on the ground. The leg closest to the ground is bent. The other leg is straight. I put this arm out here, so I'm not pushing at all with this arm. It's just for some balance, I guess. Put this arm behind your head and crunch up. Crunch up. And make sure you're going up instead of out, because then this will make it better on your obliques right here. And you don't need to be completely sideways. Like, this would be my side facing the ceiling. Have right here facing the ceiling so that it does your actual obliques and not your like sides. I mean, you can do both, but just up and down, up and down. And remember, with every exercise you do, when you're going up or engaging the muscle, you want to breathe out. When you're coming down, breathe in. Out, in, out, in. Let's do five, four, three, two, and one. Okay, now switch to the other side. You don't want these muscles to be stronger than these ones. This leg bent, this leg straight. It's kind of hard to keep your leg on the ground sometimes, but try to. Just lay this on out and up, up. Breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. And engage your obliques, engage your core. Make sure you're not lifting with your arm or neck, you're lifting with your stomach. And you want to keep them tight. And strengthen your core each time you go up, like kind of flex each time. Lily, you're in the camera. Okay, push it. Five, four, three, two, and one. Okay. Now, let's see what other ones. Okay, this one's a leg lift with, I don't know what you would call it. In P90X, they call it heels to heaven, so let's just call it that. So this does your lower abs plus another exercise incorporated that does your upper abs. So you want to keep your core tight the entire time with this one. This one is pretty difficult, but we got it, don't we? So, lay flat on your back, put your hands behind your head, feet together, legs straight, breathe out and lift up. And when you lift up, bring your butt up like that. It'll be kind of a quick movement there. Bring them down slowly, go up as fast as you can, and up, down, breathe out. Keep breathing, keep breathing. Go down slowly, up, And when you bring your legs up like that and like push it up, I guess, make sure you're not just like forcing your legs up and they're completely straight, they're 90 degrees, like with your body like that. And you push them straight up with your core. Don't just use momentum from your body, like going up, just do that. You can point your toes out or flat, it doesn't matter. And let's go, 5, 4, these are difficult, I love them. 3, 2, one more. And one, woo! Okay, I already did some abs today, so I'm a little sore already, but we got this, we got it, don't we? Okay, these ones, our mountain climbers, you might know what these are, but we're gonna do something, kind of different. You're gonna cross your legs when you do it. So, mountain climber, you get in a plank position, and you put one leg forward at a time. You're crossing knee to opposite elbow, like that. You can go slow or fast, it doesn't matter. And engage your core every time. Flex, flex. This does your entire core, your lower abs, upper abs, and obliques. Because every time you do this, it does your obliques and upper abs. Every time like this, it does your entire core. So let's do 10 on each side. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, come on, you got it, 7, wait, I can't count. 5, 4, 3, 2, and one more. 1. Stretch it out. If you want to stretch out your abs, get kind of on the ground. Push yourself up. And just push your chest up and head back. Make sure your shoulders aren't down like this. Make sure they're up. And you should feel a stretch all in your core right here. Okay, the next exercise is our push throughs. So, this is kind of just like a crunch, but it's, I don't know, I feel like it's a little bit better. Well, it's not a crunch, it's a sit up, but I feel like these are a little bit better. So, legs down. You're gonna put one hand on top of the other, and instead of going outward, you're gonna go up. So go out and up, kind of. It's, yeah, I didn't say that right. You're supposed to go out, and once you reach about here, then go up. And because that's what a lot of people think of the setup, you're just going boom, boom, like going like down, kind of. But no, it's the whole motion, like keeping your back kind of straight and going up, so you engage all of your core. So this, you breathe in, going down, and breathe out, going forward. And make sure you don't let your arms do all the work. I know a lot of people that do like 200, 300 sit-ups in a row. That shouldn't happen. If you're doing them right, you shouldn't be able to do that many in a row, because all they're doing is bringing their arms back and going like that and pushing themselves forward with their arms. That doesn't do anything to your core. If you want to actually engage your core, go slow and don't like keep the momentum from you. Oh, I can't talk in this video. Oh my gosh. Don't use the momentum from your arms. Use your own just core strength to do it. You should be going just slow and do about 20 of these. This should be enough. So I mean, you can put your arms back to get a little break. And go out and up. And engage your core. Go slow down. Crunches should be like this, or sit-ups, or whatever. You shouldn't be going fast with almost any exercise that has to do with your core, or anything else but cardio. Cardio, you go fast. You know, you run, you bike, you do things like that. You want to go fast to increase your heart rate, but for these to actually work the muscles that you're supposed to be working on, go slow and steady and do the right form the right way. It's better to do slow exercises with less reps than really fast exercises with more reps if you're not doing cardio, for the most part, because then you're using the correct form, you're focusing, you're engaging those muscles, you're breathing at the right pace, and let's do 5, 4, 3, two more, let's go, 2, 1. All right, I think there's only one more exercise to do, and we'll be done. Yes, they are bicycle crunches. I've done these in a lot of other videos, so you might know what they are. These do your obliques and lower abs, and a little bit of upper abs too, because you kind of crunch up, so this kind of engages your whole core as well. So basically, legs straight off the ground, hands behind your head, opposite arm to opposite knee. These should be slow as well. Breathe in, breathe up, out. You should crunch up, not pulling your neck up, pulling your stomach up with your core. Hear my breathing? That's what it should be like. You should hold your breath. Keep your core tight the entire time. Let's go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, halfway there, 4, 3, 2, and woohoo! It's hard to talk while doing exercises. Like, this is the most difficult part. It's not even doing exercises, it's talking, making sure you understand me while doing them. That's hard. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And also subscribe to my personal channel I just made. It's in the link down below. So yeah, if this helped you, if you like this workout, if you want to see more, anything like that, comment down below so I know.